Hey guys, so today's video is going to be a tag video. I love the app called Booksamino. If you've never heard of it, it's basically like Tumblr, Twitter, Facebook, all jumbled up for books. So you can post, you know, polls, ask people like, what book should I read next? Like, what books are you loving at the moment? Or you could just post blog posts, like what you think about things, book related. You can review books, you can do anything you want on it, and it's amazing. So one day I was just scrolling through and I saw this tag that someone did called the social media book tag. I was like, I want to do that. That sounds awesome. So that's what I'm going to be doing for you guys today. So the first one is Skype, and that is a book with characters that you wish you could talk to instead of just reading about. And that one for me has to be Lola and the Boy Next Door. Ever since I read this book, I have had the biggest crush on Cricket. So yeah, I want to talk to Cricket in real life. I'm so lame. I just want to talk to Cricket. Someone, please let me Skype Cricket in real life. Like, Stephanie Perkins needs to find a real life Cricket and send him to my house. So the next social media is Goodreads, and that is a book that you recommend to everyone. So currently, I recommend the Selection series or the Luna Chronicles series to anyone that I talk to who likes to read. My brother's girlfriend, hey Sadie if you're watching, I have been bugging her for almost a year to read the Selection series, and she has not. And my other friend, Christine, hey Christine if you're watching, I have been bugging her to start reading the Luna Chronicles series because they are both so good. Oh my god, I'm gonna start Crest tonight, and I'm so excited because everyone says that that's their favorite book in the Luna Chronicles series, but yeah. My Goodreads pick is the Selection series and the Luna Chronicles series. The next social media is YouTube, a book you wish that could be turned into a movie. This one was kind of hard for me because one of the books that I really want to be turned into a movie, I know that they will screw it up. So I just picked a simple contemporary that I think would be fun to watch actually play out. That is Fangirl by Rainbow Rowell. I absolutely adored this book so much. I feel like there wouldn't be many parts in this book that they could screw up for a movie. I also feel like this maybe could happen, like The Duff. If you ever read the book The Duff and then watched the movie, they're two separate storylines completely. It's horrible. But I feel like somehow they would screw this up. It's so simple, it's so easy. I don't know how they would screw it up, but I feel like they would. But my pick for the YouTube social media would be Fangirl. The next social media is Instagram, a book that you had to immediately Instagram about it because it was so beautiful. And this one also was kind of hard for me because I just got into like a Bookstagram. Like, I just made a Bookstagram called Lauren's Library. Look me up on Instagram if you want to see my pictures of books. So it was kind of hard to me for pick because I just started taking pictures of the books. But one of the first pictures that are on my Instagram is The Winter's Kiss by Marie Ratajkowski. I absolutely adore these covers. They're so beautiful. I had to take a picture of this series immediately and put it on my Instagram. The next social media is MySpace, a book that you can't remember if you liked it or not. I picked two books from my middle school time because I was a big reader in middle school, and then I hit high school and then I didn't read, and then I ended high school and I was like, oh my god, I want to read again. So all the books that were on my shelf, you know, I forgot about them. I don't remember if I liked them or not, but I'm a really big sucker for anything Romeo and Juliet. So the two books are the Romeo and Juliet Code by Phoebe Stone and The Juliet Club by Suzanne Harper. I think I remember liking this book, but I don't even remember if I read this one, but I feel like I did read it. I'm not sure. So that's why it's MySpace, because like MySpace was a thing and then like people forgot about it. I don't know. I never had MySpace. I was not one of those people. So I really don't know what MySpace is about. But yeah, my pick is these two books for MySpace. So the next social media is Tumblr, which is a site that I enjoy a lot, and I love looking at pictures of other people's books. But the thing about Tumblr is a book that you read before it was cool. I'm not cool enough to read books before they're cool. I literally, all the books that I read, I find out from other booktubers or Booklr, which is Book Tumblr, or Bookstagram, which is, you know, Instagram for books, like, or other friends recommending me. I don't read books before they're cool, so I don't have a book for this category. I literally don't read books before they're cool because I read them because they are cool. So the next social media is Facebook, a book that everyone pressured you into reading. No one really pressured me into reading any books, except Christine might have pressured me into reading the Selection series and then I loved it, but I'm not gonna pick that one for this because I save the Selection for everything. But the book that I'm going to be picking is The Winner's Curse by Marie Ratajkowski. No one actually pressured me into reading this book, but every single video that I watched before I bought this book on YouTube about books, every booktuber was saying something amazing about this book. So it kind of pressured me into it because the cover was so pretty. I was like, I want to buy it just because of the cover, and then I read it. So I'm just going to use this one as my Facebook. That one was also kind of hard for me because no one like pressures me into reading any books. So yeah, The Winner's Curse. The last book is Twitter, your favorite shortest book that you've ever read. And for me, that one is Saving Juliet by Suzanne Selfers. I just recently read this the end of last semester during the fall semester, and it's really, really tiny, and it was a really quick read, but it was so good. Like I said earlier in this video, I'm a sucker for anything Romeo and Juliet, like related, anything. It was so good. So that was my social media book tag. Comment down below and tell me what your picks would be for all the different social medias. I'll have in the discussion bar below each social media and its question behind it so someone else can do this. I'm gonna tag some people that I don't know if they'll ever see this video or will ever do this, but I'm gonna tag Maureen Keevy. She's an awesome, awesome booktuber. I enjoy watching her books so much. And I also tag Read by Zoe. I don't know if Zoe will ever see this video or Maureen, but if y'all ever see this video, I tag y'all to do this. And I also tag anyone else who watches this video who would want to do this. So I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys later. Bye! My sweatshirt says Internet Kids Never Sleep. I wore this specifically for this video. I am a loser, just like I said on the Tumblr one. I'm not cool. I am a loser.